Hello, everyone. Welcome to Vampire the Masquerade, Bloodlines, an action RPG made by Troika Games. Now, there's a lot of history behind this game, so let me try to sum it up for those that don't know. Okay, this game came out in 2004 and was built on a really early version of Valve's Source Engine. Development wasn't going very smoothly, let's just say that, and Troika was running out of money. The game came out basically unfinished. Troika released a few patches, and then promptly shut down because they went out of business, leaving the game in a very sorry state. Since then, it's gone on to become a cult classic, and the fans have kept improving the game with patches of their own, even to this day. Now, I'm going to be using the unofficial patch, version 8.8, which fixes about a million bugs and even restores content that was meant to be in but never made it in for whatever reason. It also has a widescreen patch and, yeah, just fixes a bunch of stuff. So much stuff. I'll have a link in the description to a guide that details all of the patches and how to fix some common issues modern computers have with running the game. Also, Vampire the Masquerade Bloodlines is available from many places online, including Steam, so links to all of that will be in the description as well. So that is the quick summary of the history of this game. And there is a lot more to it, oh my god, is there? There's so much to talk about, but I'll try to keep it brief. It's hard for me to keep it brief, but I'll try to. Okay, so I've played this game before. A very long time ago. I don't remember when, but it was a long time ago. I was quite young, and I only have vague memories of it. But I remember loving it. I remember loving it a lot, and also being frustrated by all of the bugs, but I really, really remember liking it. That's about all I remember. It's a very vague memory. But there's that. And then this game went on sale in the Halloween sale on Steam, and it was, I think, $5, and I thought, okay, I need to play it again. It's been so long since I've played it. I barely remember it, so it'll be as if it's new. And frankly, I don't think I was old enough to even really appreciate just how good the game was back then. So, the thing is though, it's a really complex game. It's an RPG, and there's lots of stats, and there's lots of systems to learn, and there's just a lot. So I didn't want to go into it just blind and stumble over everything, because realistically, I would spend probably like a half hour just in the stats menu trying to figure out what the hell I'm doing. So I've now just refreshed my memory on this game. I've played it for a little while just to familiarize myself with everything, so that this process that I'm about to do of creating a new character will not be so painful. Okay. Are you ready? Oh yes, I should mention, the thing I want to do in this game, the thing that will make me satisfied, no matter what else happens in this game, no matter what else happens, if I do this one thing, I will be happy with this game, and I will feel blissful, and that is, if I can dance at the asylum. If you haven't played the game before, you probably don't know what that is. But I'll just say, that is my goal. If I can get there, then that's all I need to be happy. God, I love the asylum. I have such fond memories of the place. You'll see. Okay. Alright, let's get into the stat-heavy business of creating a new character. New game. The world of darkness is a place where immortal monsters pulled the strings of humanity. Okay, and it disappeared before I could finish reading it. Okay. So this is a really cool little thing that I've actually never seen in a game before. I don't know if it's maybe common in RPGs, which I don't play all that often, so that's why I haven't seen it, but it's really, really cool. So you can choose to answer a series of questions about the type of vampire you'd like to play and allow the game to create your character, or just go directly to creating the character yourself. So when I first played this, I went through the series of questions, and it's actually really cool. You just answer a bunch of questions about how you would respond to different situations, and it creates your vampire's stats and clan and all of that. Based on that. Now, I think that's really cool, but personally it drives me a little bit crazy because after I create my character, I look at the stats sheet and look at where all of the points went to, and I think, oh, but maybe I should move that there, and oh, wait, no, I think that's better if it goes there, and then I'm left with just being at the same point as if I just created my character from scratch to begin with. So I'm not going to do the series of questions. Let's just create our character from scratch. Okay. This game has an insane amount of customizability. Maybe not necessarily so much with like the visuals of your character, but there's just so much you can do to your character that has such a massive influence on how you play through the game. Let me demonstrate. You can choose which clan you want to be in. Out of all of these, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, there are seven different clans, all of which look different. For example, here's the Brujas. Here's the Gangrels. Here's the Malkavians. They all look different. And that's not it. It's not just a visual change. I'm assuming it affects how you're perceived in the story based on, you know, the standing of your clan and whatnot, but it does a bunch of other stuff as well. It changes your stats, it changes your special abilities, it just changes so much. So I'm pretty sure I could probably play through this game again as a very different character and get a almost entirely new experience. So there's actually a pretty good chance I'm going to want to replay this game, assuming I like this playthrough, which I probably will. Alright, so there's some general descriptions here for what all these different clans are. Passionate, idealists, and rebels. And then the Gangrels, as you might imagine, based on the fact that of that pose, they're kind of wild loners. And here's an interesting one that probably makes the most extreme difference in the game from what I've heard. That's the Nosferatu, which you might want to turn away if you're easily scared, because this thing is horrifying. Not so much the male version of it, but the female version is one of the most disturbing things I've ever seen. I might have nightmares about that. And it affects a bunch of stuff. Yeah, so you're trying to... You have humanity up here. And... Oh god, how do I even explain all of this? Okay, you have humanity up here, and up here on the right, you also have masquerade violations, I believe they're called. So basically, you, in general, want to pass as a human. You don't want to be seen as like a beast or a danger. So you have to kind of hide your abilities from humans when you're playing all these other classes. Because they all look human, right? All these clans look human. So you can pretty easily pass as a human, so long as you don't use your special abilities. However, if you are a Nosferatu, you don't even look close to a human. Simply your existence makes you... Well, you can't just walk out on the street. You have to basically, I think, remain in the shadows. Yeah, Nosferatu are masters of the shadows. Due to their curse, Nosferatu have a seduction of zero, yep. Can never raise it higher, and they hide their existence from common humans. So you could actually play a clan where you have to hide your entire existence from all of the humans in the game. The amount of things you can change in this game, and the kind of different playthroughs you can get, and the fact that the game actually supports all of these playthroughs, you know, with unique options to suit your character, is amazing. But anyway, I could probably spend like 5 hours just talking about all the different options and how cool they are in this game. But let me pick a clan. So I'm going to go with Toreador. I hope I'm pronouncing that correctly. And normally I play a male, but I'm trying to change things up and stop playing characters that are incredibly like me, so this time I'm going to choose a female. And I've already set my name here. For some reason I had it in automatically, I'm not sure why, but... I'm naming her Nellavanda, after a Nuridari Nellavanda from the Dark Eye Chains of Satanav. Just like this part of it, Nellavanda. It sounds really cool. You can even... Oh god, there's so much more. You could even choose a history. You could be a teamster, a 20-something, a rehab counselor. You could be a slut if you want to. You could be fae-like, and all these things give you sort of a backstory and affect your stats. So for example, fae-like. Some of your abilities have greater duration, but you are a truly delicate being. It costs more experience to raise your stamina, strength, firearms, and intimidation. So all these different things affect your stats, but I'm just going to go with none, just basic. Alright, so I should mention what the Toreadors actually are. Toreador picture themselves as artists and visionaries, and they value the high society mentality that the Camarilla reinforces. Of all clans, the Toreador are the most connected to the mortal world through arts and entertainment. Toreador are beautiful creatures, svelte and seductive, and move almost effortlessly through the society of the living. The Toreador's empathy is both a gift and a burden. All humanity shifts are doubled. So yes, this is my humanity up here. I'm not exactly sure what humanity changes in the game. I think it explains it a little bit later. But yeah, they are the most connected to the human world. They are basically smooth talkers. They're not fighters. Not fighters at all. I'm not going to be focusing on combat. I'm going to be focusing on talking, persuasion, seduction. I'm going to be pretty good at seducing because damn, I look good, don't I? I really do look good. And let's get into the stats. So I'm a female Toreador. Next. Okay. Are you ready for some stats? Now don't be overwhelmed. If you haven't played this game before, or if you're not too used to RPGs, you might be freaking out when you see the screen. Don't worry, it's not too bad. I freaked out the first time I saw this too. I thought, what the hell? It's gonna take me so long to learn all of this. And well, it kind of did, but I learned it. Let's see, how can I explain this? Okay, you have attributes, abilities, and disciplines. Attributes and abilities are all included. They're all the same on all different clans, no matter who you play. However, disciplines are the things that differ between the clans. So depending on what kind of vampire you are, you'll have different disciplines. Let's see. Alright, so these are the feats. These are basically the things... I don't even know how you describe the difference between all these things. But lockpicking, sneaking, hacking... This is kind of like... I think the feats are kind of like the culmination of all of these things. Well, not your disciplines, but the abilities and the attributes. You'll see. Let's spend the points. Okay, so I have 3 points in attributes. None of which go to physical, because again, I am not focusing on strength or fighting or anything like that, so the type of character I am is not built for physical confrontations or anything like that, so I can't put any points here. I can put 2 in social and 1 in mental. Alright, so there's charisma, manipulation, and appearance. So if you mouse over one of these things, it shows you what it's going to affect in the feats on the right-hand side of the screen. You can see persuasion is lit up when I'm over charisma. Manipulation increases haggle, appearance increases seduction. So that kind of tells you what it's going to do, basically. So I have 2 points here. Okay. Manipulation is haggle. Haggle is your character's ability to estimate goods and better prices and all that. I don't really care about that. Charisma is persuasion, which is something I really care about. I'm all about persuading. And appearance is all about seduction. And as much as I want to be able to seduce, I think I want to focus on persuasion more. So I'm going to put another point into persuasion. Okay, 1 mental point. Perception changes ranged and inspection. Ranged I don't care about because I'm not focusing on combat. Inspection measures your character's ability to notice hidden details. I'm not exactly sure what that does. Intelligence increases research and intimidation. I don't care about intimidation because, again, that's not what I'm doing. I'm all about persuading people, not trying to scare them. Research is your character's ability to read books and learn new abilities. Okay, but wits affects defense and hacking, and I love hacking in games. If there's an ability for me to hack in a game, I will take it, always. And the computer hacking sort of mini-game, if you can call it that, inside of this game is actually really, really cool. It's really fun. So I definitely want to focus on hacking. And defense is always good because, again, I'm not focusing on combat, so hopefully I can survive long enough to not have to shoot people too much. So let's just put our point in wits. Okay, 3 talents, 1 skill, 2 knowledge. Okay, brawl, don't care. That's, yeah, intimidate, don't care. Subterfuge, increases seduction. I'll put a point into that. Yeah, because I do want to focus on seduction. Dodge is very important because I need to be able to avoid getting hit because I'm not focusing on combat. So that would be nice. Should I put 1 more point in dodge or 1 more in subterfuge? Let's put another one in subterfuge, because hopefully I can avoid combat altogether, right? I mean, you don't need to dodge if you're not getting shot at or hit. So let's go with that. Okay, 1 skill, firearms, don't care, melee, don't care. Okay, security and stealth, these I do care about. Security affects lockpicking, which is in the same sort of vein as hacking. Sneaking is also sort of in the same sort of vein. It's all about staying in the shadows and picking doors and unlocking things, so I want both. But I only have one skill point. Let's go with security. Because even if I'm not good at sneaking, I can probably still sneak. However, if I don't have a high enough lockpicking skill, I can't lockpick. So there's kind of a difference there, so I'm going with that. Alright, two knowledge. Computer increases my hacking. Obviously, I'm a hacker, so... Another point into that. Finance is haggle, don't care. Investigation is inspection. Maybe. Scholarship is research and persuasion. I'm gonna be a super hacker. Yep. Oh, yeah. Should I? I already have 3 points in hacking. That's pretty good. I feel like I should... No, I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna be a super hacker. Yep. Okay. Okay, I can put one into disciplines. I was gonna say disciples. No. Okay. I have three abilities. Auspix, if that's how you pronounce that. Auspix. Celerity and presence. Auspix is all about... Well, it says right here. Reveals the auras of the living and undead within a short distance, lasts 20 seconds per activation. And also adds 1 point to wits. And wits does what? Wits. Where's wits? Wits increases hacking and defense. Oh, so that will actually make me a better hacker. Wait, so I can become a better hacker by using Auspix. You know what? I'm going to take one more point out of computer and put it into... Persuasion? Let's put it into persuasion. Because I can increase my hacking ability. Yeah, that's good. So Auspix... Basically, Auspix is good for... Aside from just enhancing your abilities to use for hacking and whatnot, is also good for showing you where enemies are, which is vital for sneaking. So you can see them behind a wall and stuff like that before you're seen. Celerity is... Well, vampiric pre... What does that say? Preternatural? What? Whatever, allows you to do super speed. The world will seem too slow while you remain unaffected. So it's kind of like slow motion, except you're not in slow motion. And as it says, all but the first levels of Celerity are obvious supernatural acts, and using them in safe areas is considered a violation of the Masquerade. In other words, you will get a Masquerade violation up here if you use anything but level 1 in a safe zone and someone sees you. Actually, I don't even think someone needs to see you. I'm pretty sure if you just use it in a safe zone, no matter what, I think you'll get a violation. I'm not really sure. And presence is kind of the... I guess the core of my clan, because we're all about talking and persuasion and things like that, and it strikes mortal fear into the hearts of their opponents, reduces enemies' effectiveness, and a bunch of other things. So it's all about, well, presence. You know, I am big and I am smart, and my mind will beat your body, I guess. And that's what it's all about. But I really want to focus on sneaking and avoiding to supplement my security and my stealth and my hacking and all of that, so I'm going to put one into Auspix. Auspex? So that I can sneak better. Okay. All points have been assigned. So I am going to be Nellavanda, the Toreador artiste with a penchant for hacking and talking people into doing whatever I want them to do. And also seducing them. That is my character. Alright, I believe it's time to go. Let me mention one thing very briefly before the game begins. This game, even with all of the patches, all of the fixes from the unofficial patch and all of that, is still extraordinarily unpolished. I'm assuming the patches have focused more on bug fixing and restoring lost content and making the game usable rather than polish. Because it's really unpolished. Just, if you haven't played this game before, you haven't seen it before, just prepare yourselves. It's really unpolished. But if you look past that stuff, I'm pretty sure what you're going to find, and I guess we'll be discovering this together, because it's been a while since I've played this game, and I'm running off of memory here, but all we have to do is look past all of the unpolished stuff and look to the golden center. Because this game is really, really damn special. And I can't wait to get into it. I'm going to have a lot of fun with this. Okay, let's go.
I want to show you something.
Good evening. My fellow kindred, my apologies for disrupting any business or interfering with prior engagements you may have had this evening. It's unfortunate that the affair that gathers us together tonight is a troubling one. We are here because the laws that bind our society, the laws that are the fabric of our existence, have been broken. As prince, I am within my rights to grant or deny the kindred of this city the privilege of siring. Many of you have come to me seeking permission, and I have endorsed some of these requests. However, the accused that sits before you tonight was not refused permission. Indeed, my permission was never sought at all. They were caught shortly after the embrace of this child. It pains me to announce the sentence, as up to tonight I considered the accused a loyal and upstanding member of our organization. But as some of you may know, the penalty for this transgression is death. Know that I am no more adjudicator than I am a servant to the law that governs us all. Let tonight's proceedings serve as a reminder to our community that we must adhere to the code that binds our society, lest we endanger all of our blood. Forgive me. Let the penalty commence. Which leads to the fate of the ill-begotten progeny. Without a sire, most child are doomed to walk the earth never knowing their place, their responsibility, and most importantly, the laws they must obey. Therefore, I have decided that...
This is bullshit!
If Mr. Rodriguez would let me finish, I have decided to let this kindred live. They shall be instructed in the ways of our kind and be granted the same rights. Let no one say I am unsympathetic to the plights and causes of this community. I thank you all for attending these proceedings. And I hope their significance is not lost. Good evening. Your sire, tragic, my apologies. But you see, there is a strict code of conduct that all of us must adhere to if we wish to survive. When someone, anyone, breaks these laws, they undermine the well-worn fabric of our centuries-old society. Understand my predicament. Allowing you to live makes me directly responsible for your subsequent behavior. So, what I'm offering is not generosity, but the opportunity to transcend the fate woven by your sire. This is your trial. You will be brought to Santa Monica. There you will meet an agent by the name of Mercurio. He will provide the details of your labor. I've shown you great clemency. Prove it was more than a wasted gesture, fledgling. Don't come back, Until you do. Good evening.
Alright, here we go. We're entering the tutorial section. So yes, you might have noticed that there's about a million things that needed polish in that intro. I could probably spend just an hour going over all of them. But I won't. Just suffice it to say, as a general rule, that this game is extremely unpolished in about a million ways. But again, if you look past it, it also has a lot to offer, so much. It does some really, really cool things. Alright, so yeah, it's telling me how to look around. I know how to look around. Item gained, key to pawn shop lodgings, room 508. Okay, so one strange thing about the game is that it is third person and first person. You can switch between the two. And unfortunately, you kind of need to use both. Some are better for some situations, and the other one is better for different situations. Which ends up with the... well, it's awkward. Because you have to keep switching, and yeah, it's just weird. I feel like third person is better for exploring in general, just because... I don't know, I feel more... part of the world, because I can see my character actually moving within it. So I'm going to stick with third person here.
What a scene, man! Woo-wee! They just plop you out here like a naked baby in the woods. How about that? Look, kiddo, it's probably a lot for you to take in, so why don't you let me show you the ropes? What do you say?
Who are you?
I'm Jack. What's important is I'm offering help. You make it back from Santa Monica with your hide, and we'll trade life stories, okay? Till then, I got about this much time. You in or out?
All right, so I guess this is kind of like whether you want to go into the tutorial or not. So yes, I do. Okay, I could use the help.
All right. Why don't we step out back here?
I like it where I am. At least I'm out of the theater.
Christ, it's stuffy in there, huh? This is much better. Now, we ain't got much time, but I figure somebody should fill you in on the bare bones stuff at least. You know, could save your hide. You look wobbly. You even had a drink yet?
I don't even remember.
Oh, man, we're popping a cherry here. Ha, ha, ha. Oh, you're gonna love this. All right, check it out. Blood, it's your new rack of lamb, your new champagne, blood, your new fucking heroin, kid. Get ready, though, because, hey, it's never as sweet as the first time.
What do I do?
Well, down around the corner there, I saw this human. Poor SOB can't find his car.
I love the voice acting in this game. It's so good in general. There are some exceptions, but he is not one of the exceptions. He is really well voice acted. So, what do
Alright. You go down there, casual like. You creep up on him, you bear those little fangs and feed. Don't worry if you weren't captain of the wrestling team or something, because it'll come so naturally you think you've done it 1,000 times already.
Won't he become a vampire then?
Forget that comic book crap, kid. It don't work that way. Now go for it. Be sure, though, and this is important, so listen up. Be sure not to drain him dry, okay? It might be hard to resist, but don't kill him.
All right, so it's just explaining the blood pool and the feeding and all of that. I think there's probably another pop-up here. Yeah, okay. Yep. All right, so my blood pool is on the... yeah, there's a lot of stuff to look at. A lot of gauges and stuff. My blood pool is on the right. It's currently at about half, as you can see. Down at the bottom of the blood pool thing, there is a ability. I can switch them with the scroll wheel, and that is whatever ability you want to use, and it uses up your blood. So your blood is like your pool of... I mean, I guess it's basically like your mana, really. It's the same kind of idea. It's your energy source for using your abilities. So for example, if I use Auspex, which allows me to see the outlines of people, let's see if I can see them through the wall. Not quite. Oh, is that really where it activates from? That is pretty long short distance. But anyway, yes, that uses up blood. And my health is on the left, that's the blue thing. So, let's get some more blood. Let's feed. Yes. And that's his blood pool at the top. If you let it go all the way down, they will die, so you do not want to bleed them dry. I need to stop before it's all gone, right about now. Okay. Full blood, and he is okay. Although, a little bit dazed. Yeah, he's not having a good day. Whee, I can jump. You know what's really fun to do? Jump up in the air and punch the wall. Oh yeah. By the way, this game has absolutely ridiculously insane dynamic range in the audio. So if things are too loud, if some things are too loud or the voices are too quiet, I'm sorry, the audio is just fucked up. I tried my best. I'm gonna try my best when it comes to mixing the audio for this game, but it is crazy. I'm pretty sure the voices are just going to be too low. We'll see.
Yeah. Yeah. Hell yeah, you're feeling it. I can see it in your eyes. You're a born-again predator. Feeling that blood bubbling inside you, lifting you up. That's it, kid. That's what it's all about right there.
And the writing in this game is so good. It's one of the best parts about it. It's just incredibly strong writing. Everywhere. Just everywhere. And all of your responses and all of the things people say to you and all the things you can say to them. Great. When do I get my cape? Do I get to pick the color? That's the smart-ass response you could go with. But I won't. I'll go with, I don't know how I feel about it, but it does feel good.
Alright now, you got the blood, you're feeling all kick-ass, feeling better than your best day living, but wait, it gets better. All kindred, that's a our word for vampire. All kindred have a few things in common. Things that set them right square above humans on the food chain.
Yeah, like what?
Like sharper senses, a body that can take a beating, and if you play your cards right, eternal life. That's no sure bet, but still, a chance at immortality is not a bad deal. And that's just for starters. Fringe benefits for joining the club.
So I'm going to live forever?
Well, you can still be destroyed, but forget the books and the movies. Garlic? It's worthless. A cross? Pfft, shove it right up their ass. A steak? Only if it catches you in the heart, and then it just paralyzes you. Running water? That's no problem. I bathe. Occasionally. Now, a shotgun blast to the head. Oh, that's trouble, boy. Fire? That's real trouble. Sunlight? Well, you catch a sunrise and it's all over, kiddo. Get it?
Got it.
Okay, now. What the fuck is this? You get inside here and head upstairs. We'll meet up in a bit. I'm just gonna go see what the ruckus is.
That sounds like a good idea, because it sounds like someone's doing a hit and run. Let's go. Alright, that's just telling me how to use doors and stuff, which I already know. Okay, and that's gonna tell me how to jump. Yes, you jump with the space key. So in this sort of a situation, it might be better to be in first person. Your feats are the combination of various abilities and attributes. The higher your feats score, the better you are at the activities they influence. Inspection is a feat. It is a combination of perception and investigation. It allows you to see hidden and secret things. For example, the lockpick on the crate in front of you. Right. You can pick up objects in the world. Yep. So apparently my inspection ability allowed me to see this. Now I have a lockpick. Let's take a look. Here's what I have in my inventory. I have a key ring with a couple keys. I have a wallet with no money in it. Yay, I'm poor. And a lockpick. Also, for melee weapons, I have my fists. I have no weapons, and these are my clothes.
Come down here. Stay away from the windows. Oh, it's a Sabbat raid. Sabbat? They're, Christ, I was hoping to spare you this shit till later. The Sabbat. Well, They're mostly mindless, bloodthirsty assholes. That's all you need to know for now, all right?
So what's up?
The Sabbat got wind of the gathering here, so they figured they'd raise a little hell and put a little heat on the new prince.
What's the prince a prince of?
No time for political rundown. Job one, get out of here alive. Sabbat might be mindless, but they hit like a Mack truck, like raging savages. Nothing a fledgling like you wants to mess with.
What am I supposed to do?
Shh. Heads up. Back away. Bastards. All right, we gotta vamoose out the back quick. I'll stay and keep a watch out. You get us into the office. The door's around the corner here.
I'm on it. Are this telling me how to use my quest log? Yep, this is my quest log. Active quests. A vicious vampire faction known as the Sabbat has launched an assault on the secret Camarilla gathering downtown. You and Jack are caught in the middle. To escape, you must obtain entry into the office. Also, one strange thing I noticed about this hallway. You might not notice it all that much if you're in first person, but when you go into third person, you notice something about the scale of the doors? It feels like the world, like this entire hallway, has been sized up. I feel like either I'm a miniature or this is a very, very oversized hallway. I don't know, there's something very strange about it. They just seem way too big. Alright, yeah, that's just telling me I can lock stuff, lock picking, a combination of dexterity and security. Mm-hmm. Yep. So if I have a high enough ability, I can lock pick it, which my lock picking ability is 2. It is a combination of security and dexterity. My security is 1, my dexterity is 1, so my lock picking is 2. Whoops. So I think it's either a pass or fail sort of thing. You either have the ability to lockpick or you don't. There's no real minigame, it's just a stat check, basically. Yeah, it says in the top right, succeed at lock difficulty 1. So this has a lock difficulty of 1, and I have a lockpicking of 2. So yeah, I guess if you have equal or greater lockpicking skill, you can pick it. If you have less, you can't. And this asshole over here just broke through the window. Very elegant, good job.
Shortcut. Well, nicely done, though. Not exactly an angel in life, were you?
I had my moments.
Cool. Now, if you want a lesson on how really not to act, take notes from those Sabbat assholes. You're a big bad vampire. Yeah, great, congrats. Now keep it to yourself. You go roar and you beat your chest and that's what you can expect.
Wait, I've still got that list of people from high school. Why not?
It's the same reason you don't let humans see you feeding. It's why the wolf doesn't want the sheep to know he's there. It's also why you don't go juggling dumpsters or outrun the 815 from Sacramento, and it's why you didn't know any of this when you woke up this morning.
Ah, I get it.
Keep our secret secret and you make things easier on all of us. We're living in the age of cell phone cameras. Fuck-ups ain't tolerated. Makes sense enough, right? Well, it ain't a casual thing for a fledgling like you.
What do you mean? What could happen?
That party back there with the guy in the suit and the Magilla Gorilla? The assholes that put your sire to death? That's the Camarilla. They make a tidy business out of enforcing vampire laws like this one.
I see.
All right, now don't worry, because I know the area a little, and you know what? I'm glad we're in this situation, you and I. It illustrates a point. You gotta utilize your surroundings.
Ooh, I like the sound of this. Okay, but what does that mean exactly?
You do what you gotta do. Theft, destruction of property, breaking and entering. These'll be the least of your sins before the night's out. So look around here. We gotta get out the back there through that magnetically sealed door. There must be a key someplace.
I'll find it. Alright, this... I'm not sure why it tells you this here, but... Yeah, that's the area indicator at the top of my health bar on the left. Basically, it's either a battle zone, a masquerade zone, where you need to respect the masquerade. Don't do anything suspicious, basically. Or it's an Elysium. Vampire neutral ground, no combat or disciplines are allowed except blood buff while lockpicking. Yep, in masquerade areas, breaking the masquerade can carry dire consequences, such as the unwanted attention of vampire hunters. After 5 masquerade violations, your game is over. Your current number of violations is displayed in the upper right corner of your character sheet. Yep, so that'd be this. I have 0 masquerade violations, of course. So yes, this game has a lot of systems. Health bars and abilities and tons of stats and zones and... There's a lot to learn. It's pretty damn complex. Alright, so this is how to use computers. And that is how to hack. Yeah, so the hacking system is actually really cool. It's not a ridiculous little mini-game, really. Nor is it a simple stat check. It's actually kind of a combination. It's pretty neat. The thing is, you don't need to hack a computer to be able to access it. You could find out the password through other means. So if you could maybe get the password out of someone, or find it on a piece of paper, for example, this piece of paper here actually tells you the password. Chop shop. So if you can get the password through some other means, you can simply enter it, but you can also hack the computer in addition. So let's use the computer. Whoops, I did not mean to punch the computer. So let's try that again. So there's an actual menu, and you actually have to type. Help and quit. Alright, so available menus. Safe is the only one. A password is required to enter the subdirectory. I know the password, but let's just say I didn't. You can start hacking by pressing Ctrl-C. Success! Let's enter that menu. Alright, available commands within the safe menu is unlock and lock. Unlock. Safe door is unlocked. Quit. And we're done. It's a very simple system. That's just telling me how to use a container. It's a very simple system, the whole hacking and computer system, but it's really satisfying because you have to actually type stuff. It's really cool. I like it. Alright, so everything on the left is what's in my inventory, everything on the right is what's in the container. Chop shop key is what's in the container, let's take it.
There we go, now take that keycard and head out the back. I'll meet you out in the alley there. I'm gonna check out things from topside.
Got it. Access your inventory, Yep, just telling me how to use my inventory. One important piece of information here though is that some doors have magnetic locks and cannot be picked open. They must be opened with the appropriate keycard. So not everything is lock-pickable. Alright, what's actually in this environment? Is there some cool stuff? Die, my darling. I'm guessing that's a band. And I'm guessing they play very, very happy music. Very upbeat stuff, right? Yeah, I'm sure they do. That's too blurry to read. Wait, I can actually flip the light switch? I didn't even know that. Holy crap, that is cool. Takeout menu. Why is there a menu on the ground? Also, remember, it's in the source engine, which means you can pick up objects and throw them around like a crazy person. Yep. It's so much fun. Good old Source Engine, huh? Fond memories. Fond memories of the Source Engine. Although, not everything can be picked up. In fact, most things can't. None of this can be picked up, but for some reason, this chair can. Didn't mean to punch it. Actually, I can't seem to pick it up anymore. Why can't I pick it up anymore? There we go. Let's throw it there. Goodbye, chair. Okay. Let's use my keycard. There we go. Save the game. Ugh. You've been wounded by the Sabbat. This blue bar represents your current level of health. Mm-hmm. If your health is completely depleted, you will suffer final death and your game is over. In other words, you die if you run out of health. Yes. But your health regenerates over time, and when you're feeding, your health regenerates much faster. Here's an important point. If your health bar begins to turn yellow, it means you have sustained aggravated damage. Certain hazards like fire and supernatural acts cause aggravated damage. This takes much longer to heal than regular damage. Okay, so... Well, I could kind of heal myself right now, but let's just go with the tutorial. Because I have this ability called Blood Heal, which does exactly what it sounds like it does. But let's hold off on that for now.
Fucking waste of unlife, these Sabbat Vatos. You get winged? Hey, look at them potholes. Those will close up soon enough. Better feed, though. There's someone down the stairs here. It's not the freshest catch, but he'll do.
What's the difference? Blood's blood, right?
Well, when it comes to feeding, it's quality blood you're looking for, not the quantity. Bums and lowlife don't pack the same punch that a healthy, well-bred human will. Juice bags with a pedigree, that's the good stuff. But you gotta take what you can get. You ever had a PhD, kid? Ooh, that's good stuff.
A PhD. Sounds delicious. I've never thought, what does a PhD taste like? If you say so.
Remember what I said, though. Don't kill them. At least not the innocent ones. You're a monster now. Make no mistake. One of the damned and the fallen. You need to hold on to every last shred of humanity you have.
Let's say I get a little overzealous. What happens then?
An innocent's an innocent. You kill one, even a worthless bum, even by accident, and it's gonna cost you a piece of your own humanity. Bring you closer to that beast you got welling up inside you.
The beast? What exactly does that mean?
The beast? It's always there. It's waiting to take over. When it does, it's like a wild animal wearing your skin. Desperate, scared, reckless. He'll do anything to survive, and it's you that has to deal with the consequences.
So I can't kill anyone? That seems a little, restricting.
I said innocent humans. If some asshole levels a 12 gauge your way, you drain him, skin him, and bash in his skull. Self-preservation is a vital part of humanity, after all. My favorite part, in fact.
I think I follow.
The only way to fight the beast is to keep in touch with your humanity, and don't go hungry. It's a fine line.
Got it.
All right, now go feed. Careful, though. He's gonna drain fast.
Be back in a minute. Okay. We have someone else to feed on down here. Remember, you want to avoid draining your victims. Draining innocent humans will give you a penalty to your humanity. The lower your humanity, the closer you get to the beast. If your humanity gets too low, you'll begin to lose control of your character. This is known as frenzying and may result in a masquerade violation if you are around humans. In other words, you don't want your humanity to go low. Hi. Yeah, he doesn't look too good. At all. I think he's drunk. Or on drugs or something. Because he's kind of like swaying. Anyway, let's feed. Alright, he does not have much blood, so it's kind of right there. Okay, that's good.
Not quite as good, huh? Eh, you could do worse. There's some rats down the way. You think I'm kidding? You can survive feeding on animals if you can stomach that kind of thing.
Worse than a bum's neck? That scarf tasted like old gym socks.
Well, give it a try.
I'll think about it. Rats can be fed upon to gain a single blood point. You'll find some rats at the other end of the alley, near the yellow windows. Killing rats has no impact on your humanity score. Humans do not react well when they see live rats being sucked on. So that is the one warning. Humans do not react well when they see live rats being sucked on. Which doesn't surprise me. I wouldn't react well either. Let's go feed. Hello. Yes. Delicious. I actually kind of feel bad for the rats. I mean, I didn't even need the blood. I just killed them for no reason at all. Oh well.
You rat sucker! Hey, I don't care what you do, but just so you know, polite vampire society looks down on that kind of thing.
I guess I'm supposed to be polite vampire society, aren't I? I'm supposed to be the upper echelons or whatever. The artists and the elite, I guess. But, I don't care. I'll feed on rats if I want to. But honestly, after tasting one of those, I don't blame them.
Keep it down. Got someone around the way here.
Just one guy?
Not too much of a threat by himself, but you never know if there's more in shouting range. You're gonna have to sneak past.
Sneak where?
The building across from us with the garage door. There's some double doors on the far side. I'll meet you inside. Just stay low and stick to the shadows. And don't let him see you.
I'll do my best. See you in a minute.
Alright, go.
Alright. Sneaky combination of dexterity and stealth is a feat that allows you to move among your victims and enemies without being detected. You must be crouched to sneak. Right, so that meter over there, it's... indicates the proximity of your enemies and their chance of detecting you if they are looking your way. So, green is completely safe, yellow means you might be seen if they look your way, and red means that they definitely will see you if they look in your direction. And the chance of being detected is directly tied to your sneaking feat. So the higher my sneak skill, the lower the chance of being detected. Let's go into first person for sneaking. Let's use Auspex. And of course, I'm too far away. You can see him in the green, so he's not going to see me no matter what. Good, good. So he will see me if he looks my way, but he's not looking my way, so let's go. Okay.
Keep it quiet. They're inside here. Seems that shovelhead outside just got separated from his pack. He's wounded, too. Go take care of him. Don't worry. He's probably greener than you.
That's pretty green.
The Sabbat, you see, they don't have the most rigorous training program. In fact, that poor sod is lucky if he knows he's a vampire.
How can that be?
He's probably just turned and beaten over the head. They like to do that, make shock troops, cannon fodder, put him out of his misery.
I'll do my best.
He is a vampire, so be ready.
I'll keep that in mind. See ya.
Go get him.
Alright, that's just telling me how to do unarmed combat. Yep, it's directly tied to your abilities, which, since, again, I don't focus on combat, my abilities are total crap. It's a combination of strength and brawl, both of which I have basically nothing in. And there are directional attacks as well, so you definitely want to be in third person for fighting. But so far as I've been able to see, I just suck at combat. You'll see. I kept trying to do special stuff to show some sort of skill in combat, but all I managed to do was hit them once, they hit me once, I hit them once, they hit me once, just really bad. Let's see if this goes any better. Nope, it's going the same. You can block, but it doesn't really work. It's so slow, it doesn't even block before they just hit me again, so there's really no point in using it. But it's okay, they're very weak and they don't do much damage. Oh, I can actually pick this up. Yep, just picked up a tire iron so I can switch to it. Like this.
That's that. Sounds like you got another pack moving in, though. The Sabbat are going all out. Better head underground, avoid stray bullets.
Sounds like a good strategy.
Alright, head down into the basement through the grate in there. Keep that tire iron handy. I'll be there in a minute.
I have to say, it's rather strange that there's a room here that has both industrial equipment, a grate, and a toilet. This really is a room of many uses, isn't it? So yeah, there's this pervading sense of strangeness about the environments in this game, where everything just looks... It looks too big for you, and it feels awkward in third person, and it feels awkward in first person, and it's always just a bit strange. It's very weird. Like, if you try to climb down these stairs in third person, it is, like, impossible. Like, you go invisible, and, like... It's just weird. The way it works. Oh, hi. What the hell are you doing down here? Okay. This is where probably the most fun part of the game comes in. And this is going to be where I do all of my magic. Combat is not the only solution for sticky situations. You can also use your feats and disciplines in dialogue. When you are able to do this, your responses will show up in the different colors, and when using higher resolution, different fonts that what? I think that's mistyped. But yes, responses that use your abilities basically will show up in different fancy colors and fancy fonts. As you can see down here, red one is a presence response, blue is a persuasion, the pink one that's all nice and curly is seduction, and green is intimidation.
Stop! You! Just stay back. Keep your distance.
Nope. Also, this is one of the weak points of the voice acting. I don't know why this person has terrible voice acting, but everyone else has good voice acting. So just forget about it. Don't worry about it.
Now, who the hell are you? You involved in all this? Because I'm going to radio this in, and SWAT will be all over this place.
The voice acting is so bad on him, I don't know why. It's really strange. Okay, so I can do a lot of things here. But I think persuasion is going to be my bread and butter, so I'll go with that. No, but if SWAT comes, they'll drive the gunman down here. You want that?
No. Well, I left my radio in a Caprice anyway.
There you go. Look, I'm just trying to escape. Is there another way out?
Yeah, okay. All right, this way. This will lead us up to the warehouse. We can maybe sneak out that way.
Okay, so I can have him go ahead, but no. Better stay here. It's too dangerous for you. Humanity gained! I guess I just saved his life. I guess he's probably gonna go to his death. Right, so this is talking about stealth kills. If you have a melee weapon and you sneak up behind an enemy, you can kill them. That's basically what it says. So let me get out my tire iron. Sneak up. There's a stealth kill option, and boom.
Not sure what's going on. Sounds like the Sabbat's getting scattered. I'm gonna keep an ear to the ground. Be careful going forward here. Could be a whole mess of them holed up.
Great. Just my luck. Alright, this introduces the disciplines. So your vampiric powers and cost a certain amount of blood from the blood pool to activate. Mm-hmm. An innate ability common to all vampires is blood heal, which heals you. Yep. So there's passive disciplines that directly affect you, and targeted disciplines that directly affect your enemies. Blood buff is another ability common to all vampires. Uh-huh. So it gives you a temporary bonus to all of your physical attributes. So pretty much anything, like picking a lock, you can use it to get your lockpicking skill up. Stuff like that. So blood buff is just an all-around buff. Blood heal heals you, and then I have my own class-specific abilities. Such as Auspex. Lockpicking skill below lock difficulty of 3. Okay, so in this case, I need to use blood buff. There we go. What does that take my lockpicking skill up to? 4. Takes it up to 4. Excellent. Okay. Toreador have 3 unique disciplines. Auspex, second sight, that allows you to see the auras... Or auras? 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 I think it's auras. Of others. Celerity, supernatural speed, and presence, the mystical projection of personality inspiring fear and awe. Mm-hmm. Auspex, yep, allows you to see people. Also increases your perception. Good for ranged combat and inspection feats. It is not a masquerade violation because other people can't see it. It's not obviously supernatural, so that's why. Use Auspex to see his aura. Aura? Aura, yes. To see his aura through the machinery. Mm-hmm. There we go. I see you. Now let's stealth kill him. Well, that didn't work. Hold on, let's use super speed. It doesn't seem to help at all. It literally doesn't seem to be helping at all. Yeah, I really suck at combat. And by the way, from what I've heard...
I think they're clearing out. There's no need to go stirring up the hornet's nest till we know the score, though. Head through here. You'll come to an elevator around the way.
From what I've heard, combat in this game is supposed to be one of its weakest points, unfortunately. It's really the other stuff in the game that makes it special. The clever dialogue, the ability to roleplay your character and how you interact with people. It's stuff like that, and just the variety of stuff that you can do. That is some of the strongest aspects. It's definitely not the combat. This game does not have a very interesting combat system at all. So, keep that in mind. So that's why I'm trying to not focus on combat, because combat is really just not very good. I'll meet you over there.
Meet you there. Don't let him catch you.
If I'm not there in 10 minutes, call the president. I can't believe that's actually a dialogue option. That's amazing. What exactly was that creature pressing on this thing? He was pressing buttons, as if he was manipulating it, but there aren't even any buttons here. I mean, I guess maybe there's buttons on those things, but I don't know. Presence is the power to mystically project your personality. Presence is a passive discipline. Once you activate it, pay attention to the discipline timer on the bottom right of your screen. Use of presence is not a masquerade violation. Because once again, it's not a super obvious supernatural act. There's a Sabbat guard up ahead. Use presence to frighten and then kill him. Kill him. Oh, so yeah, it's basically gonna debuff him. There we go. Okay, that went a bit better. Yeah, what does presence do here? Anyone close to me suffers a -1 penalty to strength, wits, and perception, and a reduced rate of attack. So yeah, it's just like a general debuff. Celerity? Yep. Passive for time-based. Once you activate it... Use celerity to kill him. It's very effective when used with a weapon, for example, a tire iron. Well, in my experience, it is actually not effective because it didn't seem to help at all, but okay, I'll do it again. It's really not effective at all. You'd think it would allow me to get like a bunch of attacks in before he could attack me, but nope. You might think maybe I can block, but it takes too long to block. By the time she blocks, it's already well past the time that he's already hit me. And so it's completely ineffective. It doesn't work. I can't think of any other way to do that melee fight without just basically hitting him once, he hit me once, I hit him once, he hits me once. It might just be because my stats are crap. For fighting. Maybe that's why, I don't know. I just can't really use any strategy. That I can think of, anyway. Right, when you pick up an object and throw it, you will see this use icon. To pick up an object, press the use key, and throw it. Thrown objects make noise and be used to distract your enemies. Guarding the exit and distract them. Got it.
Huh?
Yes, investigate. You are very stupid. Goodbye. Oh, hi. How the hell did you get here?
Fucking humans. Gangbangers protecting their turf. Oh, man. I'm here thinking it's Sabat moving up in here. It's the fucking locals about to take one for the hood.
So, what do we do?
They probably seen too much. Here, take this .38. Fucking pea shooter, but a few shots in it'll take down a human.
Thanks.
Well, I'm gonna want it back, so don't go die and lose it. I don't use guns much. They're noisy, they're clumsy, practically useless against vampires, but still, a kindred's gotta keep up with the times. And in modern-day Los Angeles, that means coming strapped.
Useless against vampires?
Well, yeah, some are more lethal than others, of course. Watch out for those shotguns. Ouch, those things can smart, I tell you.
I hear you.
Head up and clear out what's left. Can't have them running their mouths about any of this. I gotta make sure there's no stragglers around outside.
Okay. You have just been given a point, revolver. Mm-hmm. Range combat is a combination of perception and firearms. Yep. Alright, there are some bottles on the crate at the end of the hall. Aim your cursor, wait for it to fully focus, and use the attack key. Or I could save my ammo. Let me get it out. Whoops, I just right-clicked to use the iron sights, but that doesn't work. It uses my ability. Well, I just wasted that. Fine, it really wants me to shoot them. Fine, I'll shoot them. God, my aim is horrible. Probably because my firearm skill is... Where is it? It's zero. I have no firearm skill, literally. I have one ranged skill because I have one perception, but that's it. Come on. Come on. There we go. I am going to feed. Tastes disgusting. Come here. Oh, I can actually pick these up. What the hell? Did that bottle just go flying up? And just, like, disappeared out of this universe? Let me try that again. Where did it go? What? Report bug. What the hell? And I don't even know where the fourth bottle went. Okay. That was an interesting experience. Ooh, what is this? Ah, ammo. I will take that, thank you. Locked, can't open it. I'm assuming we're on the first floor? Yes. Second floor? Let's go to first person for this. Actually, third person might be better because you can look around corners. Oh. Alright, I don't think there's any way to stealth kill them, really. Unless, what if I combined super speed with crouching? No, it doesn't even matter. They have their backs against the wall, so time to shoot them. You can see the combat system is not exactly great. By that, I mean it's kind of terrible. Oh, hi! Nice of you to show up. Ooh, a baseball bat. Let's take a look at that. Alright, so compared to the tire iron, it has one more melee combat requirement, one more lethality. It has a -2 to feet adjustment. I don't even know what that Oh, wait, no. Sorry, I was clicking on the wrong ones. It's really close. It's very, very close. They're basically the same.
That's it, kiddo. Just like that, and it's all over. Everyone slinks back to their corners of the city for the night.
That's it? It's all over?
Until the next night, when the Camarilla finds some way to strike back. Parry, dodge, spin, and all that, and so on, and so on, and so on.
So, this is normal?
Well, to be honest, came at a, an interesting time, let's say. The Camarilla, the Sabbat. In L.A., these are the new kids on the block. There's already plenty of kindred had stakes down in California long before them. Now, we got every ancient kindred rivalry playing out all over the city. A lot of tension out there. A lot of fear. A lot of jittery, high-strung predators clinging to their little pieces of eternity.
Hmm.
Oh, boy. Oh, I think they're looking for you outside. Guess you got a cab to catch. Was hoping to fill you in on a little bit more, but... hell, you'll figure it all out.
Okay, I can use my persuasion ability here. I will, but I would like to keep the gun.
If you make it back, stop in at the last round. It's this bar downtown here. I'll fill you in on the politics. Now that's the stuff that'll kill you. Good luck.
You receive 2 experience points. Yep, by pressing C, you can access your character sheet and spend your experience points where you see fit. So I just described why I'm here on that loading screen thing, but I didn't bother to read it because I wouldn't have been able to finish it before it just, well, disappeared. So yes, this is my safe house. This is where I've been taken to in, what is it, Santa Monica? I think. Here I am, starting my new life as a vampire. It's not a bad looking place. Actually, it's kind of a terrible looking place, isn't it? Actually, it looks like this place has been burned out. This place looks disgusting. Look at this. Ugh. Lacuna Coil. That is an actual band. I think they actually have at least one song on the soundtrack of this game, actually. Alright, what's in the fridge? A blood pack. A bag of blood routinely used in hospitals for transfusions. Using it restores blood points. Should I take that? Do I need blood? I have half blood. I think I'm fine, but I might as well take it. I mean, there's no reason not to. It's a mobile blood pack. There's 2 more in the fridge. I think I'll leave those. I'll just keep 1. Yeah. Oh, you can actually move the item around yourself. What does that say on the back? I don't know what that says. It just looks like scribbles. There's everything else I had before and my lack of any money whatsoever. Can I take a shower? Because I feel kind of disgusting after eating all of those rats. Whoops. Okay, there's a watch on the ground next to the toilet. Item gained. Normal watch. Okay. And there's some pills. Pill bottle. Normal watch. This is a replica of a much nicer watch. Can't use. So, is it just for selling? What the hell do I do with this? Pill bottle. Estrogen. Caution. Do not take if male. I guess these are to sell? I'm not really sure. Ooh, what do these bottles say? I can't get any closer. Something does that say berry bloody? I can't read the other one. Green something. I love reading bottles in games. So much fun. Hold on just a second, though. I will be right back. Let's explore the rest of my apartment. Oh, God. I can't wait until I move up in the world. Hopefully I get to, because this place looks disgusting. Look at that. It's like a rotten pillow and a couple of mattresses stacked on each other and covered in filth. And there's, like, freaking particle board on my ground. On my floor. Ooh, what's in here? $100! An envelope containing a bit of cash. Well, thank you. I guess that's a bit of a boost or an allowance or something to get me started. Excellent. Could I only open one drawer? Yes. Alright, what's this? Hey, the password for your computer is Sunrise. Keep the cash in the drawer. It's yours. I dropped you an email with my address. Come on over after you get settled. Mercurio. Okay. What is this? At your convenience, please come and visit me in my home downtown. I leave you this to guide you. Dark blood, our curse. A light, this verse. Such power I sense in one so young. Come find me where burns the mystical sun. M. Strauss, Tremere Regent. Okay, it seems I have a bit of a riddle here. Check my quest log. The Regent's riddle, The Tremere Regent has invited you to his home in downtown Los Angeles. And wherefore art thou Mercurio? Prince LaCroix has dictated that you are to meet with an agent of his named Mercurio in Santa Monica, who will provide you with the details of your assignment. Okay. And I believe he gives me his address in my email. And oh my god, this computer looks so beat up. Looks like somebody dropped it from a 20-foot height a couple dozen times. And then maybe it stayed in a garbage can for a couple weeks. And then somebody rescued it. LaCroix Foundation, secure intranet. You have 5 emails. 5 are unread. Alright, looks like email's the only menu I can go to. Alright, my password is Sunrise. Okay. Well, I should start from the first one. A reminder. Mercurio will contact you when you arrive in Santa Monica. Waste no time in meeting with him. Signed, S.L. S.L. Well, it's from LaCroix, but what does S.L. actually mean? Something LaCroix. What was his first name? I don't even remember. Number 2. Dang, it's big, you know. Penis enlargement. Watch the girls come running. Call today, 1-800-555-STICK. It's from hunglow@trojanbotnet.vtm. No thanks. Kilpatrick's Crime Pewter. From arthur@dirtcheapinternet.vtm. Looking for that lazy-ass ex-husband who's late on his alimony payments? How about that jerk who knocked you up? Look no further. With Arthur Kilpatrick's amazing crime pewter, you can find almost anyone with a record. And with these days, that's just about everyone. So come on down to Arthur Kilpatrick's bail bonds. If you've got the dead beat, we've got the technology to find him. You know what the funny thing is? That's probably actually a real place I can go to. Arthur Kilpatrick's bail bonds. What do you bet that's a real place I can go to? I bet it is. Alright, welcome. From Mercurio. Hey, welcome to the town. Come on over to my place once you get situated, and we'll talk about what you'll need to get the job done. I'm going to pick up explosives right now, some astrolight. I should be back by the time you come over. I'm at 24 Main Street, in number 4. Walk to the end of the alley, and my building is the next one on the right. I'm sorry, he said, I'm going to pick up explosives right now, some astrolight. Picking up explosives. What exactly does he have in store for me? What is he planning? Why is he picking up explosives? I'm scared. Anyway, 24 Main Street. I'm gonna write that down just in case it doesn't tell me. There we go. The opening. The game begins. A pawn is moved. It says it's from a friend. Okay, that's creepy. Someone who's claiming to be my friend I'm assuming they're talking about me as the pawn. I don't have enough information to know what this is talking about, but it doesn't make me feel comfortable, that's for sure. Okay. Well, that's it. Okay, so does it tell me his address here? No, it doesn't, so I'm glad I wrote it down. Let's watch some TV.
His high-speed accident. Rivers' agent released a statement stating that Rivers' crash was due to a mechanical problem and that the studio is not pursuing legal action against Rivers for the trademark gate's destruction. Miraculously, this is the second crash Rivers has escaped unharmed in the last year. Our top story tonight, a derelict ship found floating 10 miles off the Los Angeles coast earlier this morning, was towed into the port of Los Angeles a few hours ago. The ship was spotted around midnight by fishermen who contacted the Coast Guard after their attempts to hail the ship proved futile. Coast Guard officials are releasing very little information right now, but have identified the vessel as the Elizabeth Dane. No word as of yet as to the whereabouts of the crew, though the Coast Guard are asking any ships that had contact with the Elizabeth Dane to assist them in their search. We'll have more on this story as it breaks. In other news, an apparent third victim of the Southland slasher has prompted the closing of the Santa Monica Pier, where the body was found earlier tonight. Investigators say the scene closely mirrors those of slayings in Glendale and Long Beach. In both cases, the bodies of the victims were described as torn apart, though details are being withheld from the public at this time. Police urge anyone with information relating to this case to contact them. Actor Ash Rivers is lucky to be alive after his car crashed into the gate at Parasite Studios earlier tonight. Witnesses say that they were shocked when the Negative Zero star emerged unscathed and apparently unfazed by his high-speed accident. Rivers' agent released a statement stating that Rivers' crash was due to a mechanical problem and that the studio is not pursuing legal action against Rivers for the trademark gate's destruction. Miraculously, this is the second crash Rivers has escaped unharmed in the last year. A massive gelatinous creature that washed up on the beaches of Providence, Rhode Island, has scientists scratching their heads. Found by a jogger early on Tuesday morning who says he smelled it a mile away, the mystery creature is thought to be some form of giant octopus. Though marine biologists that have examined the monster have commented that they have never seen anything like it in the cephalopod family before. They speculate that it could be from a yet undiscovered family of sea creatures. A massive gelatinous creature that washed up on the beaches of Providence, Rhode Island.
Okay, looks like it's repeating now. I think it's kind of randomized which one it goes to. That was, quite a lot of news. I wonder if the things they're talking about the murders and the Santa Monica Pier and all of that, are things I'm actually going to see in the world. I think they are. I'm pretty sure they are. Also, this is right about the point where I got to in the game, when I played it just a little while ago to get familiar with it. So I know that you can also listen to the radio, just like you can listen to the TV. However, it's really, really long, just like the TV, and I don't want to spend, like, 50 minutes just here in the apartment, so I'm going to listen to the radio some other time. I love little details like that, but let's spread it out. For now, let's go. I'd like to point out that this hallway is a little bit cramped. Because it looks like my door almost touches the wall opposite the door. Oh, whoa, 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 whoa. No, stop. I didn't know I could actually pick that. Holy shit, I can pick that. I can pick my neighbor's door. I didn't know you could do that. That is so cool. I already love this game even more than I did before. Okay, hold on. Let's see if there's anyone inside. I don't see anyone. This is awesome. Lockpicking skill below lock difficulty of 5. Oh, shit. I don't think I can get my lockpicking high enough. I believe I can boost it by 2? Hold on, I can do... Hold, let me see what presence does. I can boost it by 2 by doing blood buff, but what about presence? Presence will increase... Mm-hmm. Wait, doesn't it increase something? No, it doesn't. I thought I had something else that increased my abilities. Oh, it's Auspex that increases wits and perception. Right. None of which increase lockpicking, so no. It's not gonna work. It'll only get me up to 4. Okay, I'll have to save this for some other time. A newspaper. Quest log updated. Carnival of Death. Gruesome remains found on the pier. Police baffled. Well, that's a disturbing picture. Looks like that body's been partially eaten by something. Wait a minute, I can just open this door? It's not even locked? Wait a minute. This door doesn't even have a door handle. What? This door doesn't have a door handle. There's... How... What? I'm just gonna forget that I saw that. Alright, quest. Carnival of Death, gruesome remains were found on the Santa Monica Pier. Perhaps you should look into this. Maybe I will. Is there anyone here? No. Let's take a look. Looks like they have pizza, just like my apartment has pizza for some reason. I guess everyone has pizza, because why not? Also, his apartment looks like shit, just like mine. He's got the same burned out, like, rotten, rusting furniture. It's cool, it's cool. Seems to be all the rage. His bed looks a little bit nicer than mine, and he has 2 pillows. I only have 1. Man. That is an old-ass case. Look at that. The color of the CD drive doesn't even match the case. The case is like a white, and the CD drive is a slight gray. Also, the computer apparently doesn't work. In fact, it seems like there's literally nothing inside of the apartment. Okay, I'm gonna leave. Goodbye. Ooh, mailboxes. I guess this one is mine. And there's no mail. Okay. I don't think I can lockpick theirs. No. Here we go.
Hey, lady. You got some change, lady?
I think this is the homeless guy I fed on before. I recognize those dull, shifty eyes. You're not exactly what I wanted, but choosers can eat beggars. Anyone looking? No. Thank you. What the hell is going on over there? What was that? Should I go check it out? I'm kind of scared too. I saw a bloodstain and someone crying, and it looks like someone busted into the door. Huh. Okay, so there's a lot to explore. Look at all this. Just take a look around. Let's just take in the sights. Trips Pawn Shop. Oh, I can actually go inside of Trip's Pawn Shop? Hell yeah! Let me see if I can hawk my... What is it? My normal watch. Oh, I guess security is of the utmost importance. Hello. Nice shop you have here. Are those classic video game controllers of some sort? A microwave. Ooh. Gotta get me some of that. Yeah. Jewelry. Ooh, ooh. I want that. Is a ladder for sale? Can I buy the ladder? Please tell me it's for sale.
Hey.
Yeah?
How's it going? You, looking to buy or sell or...
You look and sound very, very high. What's your name? Let's try to persuade him.
You call me Trip. I own this shop.
Oh my god, his stare just suddenly got very intense. And now it's back to dull and lifeless. Nice to meet you, Trip.
Thanks. You, new to Santa Monica?
Yes, I am. Is it that obvious?
It's not a big surprise. We get new faces through here night after night. Used to be more tourists, but now... I don't know, man. It's more like drifters.
Why do they come here?
Beats me. Santa Monica is dead. I don't know why anyone comes out here anymore.
Santa Monica is dead. That is kind of literally true. I mean, it's full of the dead. It's full of us. Vampires. I see. I'd like to buy something.
All right, here's what we got today.
Gold ring. This looks to be a class ring. Why would I want to buy a class ring? Anyway, it's too expensive. Okay, so you can sell these things because I can buy it here. So, yeah, let's sell what I have.
Thanks for coming back. What you need?
Wait, there's no option to sell? I can't sell stuff to him? I'd like to buy something.
All right, here's what we got today.
Can I sell my stuff in this menu? Let's find out. Oh yeah, okay. The dialogue option says buy, but apparently you can sell stuff as well. $15. You know what? I shouldn't sell this stuff before I know if there's something I can do with it. It's possible these are used for something, and I have no reason to need money at the moment, so I'm actually gonna hold on to them. Goodbye, Trip. Don't smoke too much weed. I keep feeling like maybe a car is going to run me over, but I don't think cars actually exist in this game. I think people just use... Well, I mean, this is a car, obviously, but I don't think people actually drive in this game, so... It looks like this is a town where people just walk across the road as if it's a sidewalk. Hello.
Hey, honey. Looking for a date?
I am not, actually. Well, that depends. How much?
For you, honey? 50 American dollars. Best money you'll ever spend. I promise.
I don't think so. What's that on her shoulder blades? Tattoos? Or some other sort of marking? I don't know, looks interesting. Oh, she has a peace symbol. Or, not a peace symbol, a yin and yang symbol on the back of her neck as well. Ooh, do you know what that is? Remember what I mentioned about my goal in this game, if nothing else, is to dance at the asylum? There's the asylum. But we're not going there yet. Nope. This game is just filled with so many awesome details. Here's a poster for the asylum. On 2nd Street in Santa Monica, October 31st, featuring Die My Darlings and The Empire Hideous. Why, hello there. Is this your car? because your parking leaves a little bit to be desired.
Yes, is there something I can, help you with?
What are you doing?
Waiting for that blasted tow truck I called an hour ago. I'd rather not wait another second in this part of town, this time of night. Rather dreadful place, don't you think? I should have listened to my mechanic. By German, he said.
By German, yes. I quite agree. Ooh, look at all my options. I can use persuasion. Terribly sorry to bother you, my wallet's been stolen and I need to take a cab. So I can get money out of him. Or I could use my presence ability to get him to come with me. So do I want money or do I want blood? I could use some blood. You just want to admire me in private.
I've suddenly got the urge to walk down that dark and foreboding alley over there. Care to join me?
I'll meet you there. Oh yeah, I've still got it. Okay, it's much faster to run. It looks cooler if I walk. But it's so slow. Come here. Is anyone watching? Nope. Now this is some classy blood, and his animation just messed up. But just ignore that fact. Don't worry about it. Okay. Nice and full. He has more for me, so I can always come back to him. If he stays there, I don't know if he will. Oh yeah, you can actually go into the sewers. I don't know why you would want to. I'm kind of scared to see what's down here, so I'm not going to go down here just yet. Let's leave. I'm terrified at what might exist inside of the sewers in this game. Oh hey, it's you again. I see you get around.
Hey, how's it going, girl?
I'm okay. Do I know you?
Oh man, wait. Say that again.
Oh, I see. What is that homeless guy doing in the back? He is creeping me out. Look at him back there. Get out of here, dude. Creepy. Also, the police officer in the background was just dancing a little sort of jig, but he's gone. Okay. Right, so yes, you're one of those people who, I guess, has like a fetish for us, our clan. Okay. No. No, I'm not gonna play into, no. What the fuck? What just happened? It just took me out of the dialogue thing, but the dialogue is still here. What? I think the game just broke. Let's just hope this continues to work. Maybe you could hear me if you pulled your head out of your ass.
There! You go, man! You're a vampire, aren't you?
Let's say I am. What's it to you?
Hell yeah! Oh, man! I knew it! Oh, jeez, I knew you were. I just could tell. Oh, man, this is great. And I saw your teeth, and I was like, damn, it was like I could just sense you. The name's Knox Harrington. Pleasure to meet you. Oh, man.
Okay. Are you a vampire? How do you know all this?
I'm a ghoul. I didn't know about any of this stuff until a couple of months ago. When this guy just appeared, and, well, all of a sudden, bam! Whoa, man! Vampires are real and right there in front of my eyes! Blew my goddamn mind.
You said you're a ghoul? What is that?
Well, the way it was explained to me, whenever a vampire lets a human drink some of their vampire blood, the human gains a little vampire power. Can heal up quick and that kind of stuff. Jeez, oh man! And they're a ghoul and ooh, watch out.
Oh, I love the voice acting on this guy, it's perfect. I don't know, is that really a ghoul, or is it just like temporary healing powers of vampire blood? I don't know. Who was the vampire that made you a ghoul?
Aw, man! I really wish I could tell you, but I don't think I'm supposed to. But it's really cool to be talking to you just, well, because I don't get a lot of chance to talk to vampires. Oh, man! Well, other than my master. So I thought I'd just say, you know, what's up? You know?
Oh, God, this person is obnoxious. The funny thing is, this is exactly the sort of person that actually would exist in real life. These people exist. They do. They're out there. You like being a ghoul?
It's awesome! Man, after that first taste of vampire blood, it's like the best drug. Oh, man, I'm telling you, it's like... Well, it didn't mess me up. It just made me feel like I was better at everything. I felt like a god just sucking on that nasty dude's wrist.
The way he said that was perfect. I feel like a god just sucking on that nasty dude's wrist. Doesn't sound very, I don't know, it doesn't sound very romantic when he says it like that, just sucking on the nasty dude's wrist. So what are you doing around here?
Look, I probably shouldn't tell you this, but I'm on a secret mission for my master. Well, hey, it's been great talking to you, man, but I better be going. Oh, man, you know, important stuff to do.
Has anyone ever told you you're an idiot? As much as I'm thinking that, I kind of like him. So, no, I'm not going to say that. See you around. Oh, man. What the hell was that noise? I just heard a growl. I just heard a growl. What the hell? Right. So he's on a secret mission for his master. I'm really curious now. Can I follow him? Is he gonna go somewhere? I'd like to follow him. But he's not moving. Medical clinic? Can I actually go inside? Yes, I can. What's in here? Hi. Wow, this place is falling apart. Holy crap. Everything is falling apart. Good day. Good day. Hello. Hello.
Please, wait your turn and you'll be seen.
Okay, let's use some persuasion. I'm here to work on the network upstairs. I am a master hacker, after all. Well, should I do this, or should I go see Mercurio? Nah, what the hell, let's do this. I'm here to work on the network upstairs.
Nobody told me to expect any technicians.
Nobody told me to expect any stupid bitches. I don't think I'm gonna choose that option. Well, your driver conflex has a security nagle in the IP routing matrix. Call whoever is in charge. I don't care. I get paid by the minute.
Fine, whatever. Here's the key for the second floor. Stairs are down the hall. Tell the guard upstairs you're here to work on the network.
Wait, what is that second option? I just hope I'm in time to salvage the UnaVBE server? Bye? What the hell is that? I don't know. Thanks, I will. Goodbye. Oh my god, she just gave me the key. This is awesome! This is why I love this game so much. Look at the stuff you can do. Why, thank you. Clinic stairs key. Now I don't even need to sneak. I just used my powers of persuasion. I don't even know what I'm doing here, but I'm gonna do it.